Now, you'll have seen those alarming pictures from North Korea over the weekend. Let's get more now on the rising tensions between the United States and North Korea. We're joined by John Hemmings, Director of the Asia Study Center at the Henry Jackson Society. Good morning
Good
to
morning.
You. Now, a lot of people have seen those images from over the weekend of North Korea displaying its military might and parading those big missiles. How alarmed should we be by what North Korea seemed to have developed behind closed doors?
I think we should be very alarmed. I mean, this is the last of the Stalinist states. It's got a kind of bizarre foreign policy. We saw the assassination in Malaysia where they used a chemical weapon in a crowded venue. They seem to have a very high threshold when it comes to, you know, civilian casualties and extremely low on the regard for human rights, as a UN report showed in 2012. So this is a state that we don't want armed. You know, not all states are equal.
What do you think about President Trump's reaction? Because I've heard talk over the weekend of people saying North Korea have always done this. They've always tested the United States, but they have perhaps before had presidents who are more measured in their response. But Donald Trump seems to be giving as good as he gets. So is it worrying, or is it just that Donald Trump can talk as much as North Korea when it comes to bravado and look at what we've got?
You're right. I mean, there's a little bit of that. But to some extent, this has been a problem that we've put on the shelf. The Obama administration tried to do a deal with them, the leap year agreement, which the North Koreans slapped away. I mean, if we remember, Obama said during his presidential campaign that he would talk to anyone, including the North Koreans. When he had his hand slapped away, he basically refused to deal with them. So we had strategic patience for the last 8 years. So during that time, they've been building up weapon systems that now have the ability to reach the United States mainland. So when Trump and Obama met in the White House that first time, Obama did say to him, your priority is going to be North Korea.
Because North Korea can now reach somewhere like California with their missiles,
Absolutely.
Which brings it home to Americans.
Mm. Well, there's pressure on the Hill that's building up, but also the fact is they can cancel out the U.S. nuclear deterrence over South Korea. So, for example, if the North were to invade South Korea, worst case scenario, what would the United States be able to do?
It's interesting, this build-up of rhetoric, isn't it, over the last few days. One thing that struck me was that I think it was a vice foreign minister in North Korea said in an interview that we will react with a nuclear preemptive strike, which is something I've never heard before, but that is pretty serious. I mean, those sort of words are taking it to another level, aren't they?
2013, when sanctions were also put on them, they threatened a preemptive attack on the continental United States. So this is the kind of state that has a very high level of fiery rhetoric. I think they've threatened to turn Seoul into a sea of fire a number of times. And so to some extent, you have to weigh up how serious are they this time. There's a bit of a cornered animal to them in the sense that they over use language to threaten larger states.
So what do you see happening next? Obviously, the US Vice President Mike Pence is holding talks in Japan. It's meant to be about trade, but obviously will be dominated by events in North Korea. They've both agreed ahead of these talks that China should play a larger role. But in the immediate few months ahead, what do you see? How do you see this playing out?
Well, the Trump strategy is completely different from previous presidents' strategies. It may be the saloon of last chances. It is to make it's a Chinese problem and therefore needs a Chinese solution. They've tried the bilateral route with Pyongyang in the 94 agreed framework. They tried the multilateral approach in the six-party talks in 2000, which failed in 2007. So this is really about making the Chinese kind of rein in an ally, which they do have economic control over. And if you think back to the Cold War, you know, the United States stopped its allies, South Korea and Taiwan, from developing their own nuclear weapons. So this is the Americans saying, look, this is your call. And we've seen Trump up the trade talks and try to bring the economic side of it to Beijing to make it sweeten the deal.
Okay, John Hemmings, Director of the Asia Study Center at the Henry Jackson Society. Thank you very much for your insight this morning. Thank you.